हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एसिम्प्टोट्स, विच इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ हायर मैथमेटिक्स। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ द एसिम्प्टोट्स। हियर आई हैव अ बुक। दिस बुक इज वेरी फेमस इन राजस्थान, यू कैन टेल। And if you are belong to any of the university, for example Ajmer, Bikaner, Kota, Jodhpur, Vardhman, Rajasthan, Alwar, Sikar, Bharat, if any of the university you are belong, then you can take this book. So we will start asymptotes. So the basic idea of the asymptote, we have a Cartesian plane. We have a Cartesian plane and we have a curve. Let's say this is our curve. It may be any curve in terms of x and y. So then we construct a tangent on it, which go to infinity and touches a point on this curve. Let us assume this may be x comma y. So in exams you have given a equation of curve and you have to find all the given asymptotes of the curve. So there is a concept of asymptote, I will tell you. Let us take an example from this book. Let's take this example. Here we have an equation of curve and we have to find its all asymptotes. So I have a trick for you. The higher order of the asymptote is equals to the number of asymptote. Sorry, the higher order of the curve means which is the order of the curve which is equal to the number of asymptotes. Here you can see the highest order of the curve is 3. So it have 3 asymptotes. So very first, I rub this. You can write this. So here you have to differentiate. No means not differentiate, you have to distinguish them according to their orders. Here you can see it is 3 order and it is 2 order. So we can take the function in terms of m, where we put x is equal to 1 and y is equal to m. So phi in terms of m is equals to 1 plus 3m minus 4m cube. Phi 3, because it is, we write 3 due to its order of 3. So now we similarly we can find the order 2 also. It minus 1 plus m, and phi 3 m is 3. You can write this. Okay. Now we will differentiate. We put phi 3 m equal to 0. So here when we put this to 0, so 1 plus 3m minus 4m cube is 0. So we solve and find its possible roots, which are which are m is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 So here we have find the values of m, which are 1, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2. So we will proceed further. So I will rub this. So further we will move ahead. So I got to adjust the camera. So we'll further proceed. So we have find the all possible values of m. So there is a formula for. So we had find the value of all possible values of m, which are m is equal to 1, minus 1 by 2, and minus 1 by 2. Since we have similar value of m, so m is equal to minus 1 by 2. For the same value of m, we have to find two different constant, c1 and c2. So for this we have used a formula, 1 upon 2 factorial c square. Double differentiation of phi 3 m plus c, differentiation of phi 2 m, single differentiation only, plus phi 1 m is equal to 0. So 1 upon 2 c square, factorial of 2 is 2. C square
and this value comes to be minus 24, and you can see by solving the differentiation of phi 3 and double differentiate it, so you can find its value is minus 24m plus 0, it should be 0, plus m minus 1 is equal to 0. Here we get a quadratic equation in form of c and m, so we put value of m which is equal to minus 1 by 2 and get the value of c which is 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2 and get the asymptotes y is equal to minus 1 upon 2 x minus 1 upon 2. It's first asymptote and the third asymptote is y is equals to minus 1 upon 2 x plus 1 by 2. So here we get the R3 asymptotes, and that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.
And like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.